You are not smiling always. Sir, my friend, the Home Minister, has brought a constitutional amendment bill. Of course, it is a constitutional amendment bill only. It should have been brought invoking 368. That is what I have said previously. But at the same time, he is, whatever I speak, whatever I debate, he will debate with great energy, because he can make mole into mountain, mountain into mole. Sir, I can point out the five judgment, AR 1970 SC 118 on 10/10/1968. The case is between Sambat Prakash versus State of Jammu and Kashmir. So the proviso for 373 should have been adopted by a resolution. In Rajya Sabha, what I shared from my friends, the bill was introduced. There was no resolution at that time. The proviso says, invariably, the proviso should have been adopted by a resolution. Because State Assembly is not there. Yes, yes. Later thought. I agree. But whatever it is, this particular resolution should have been adopted by the President. Then only the bill should have been introduced here. They are here. Is it not late? The President should have notified after the... Sir, addressing my friend is not a sin, sir. It is all same. You are more comfortable with me, because you are always stopping me. Don't speak, stop it, listen. They are more comfortable. They are my friends only. They are not inimical to me. We were work together, sir. Don't worry about all this. We won't fight with this. They are very good friends. Of course, they are sweet enemies. No problem. Sir.
When they are in trouble, we are helped.
Sir. Sir, they say, the judgment says like this. The first argument was that this article contained temporary provision. Yesterday, my friend was saying the temporary provision. Temporary provision which is to be effective after the Constituent Assembly convened for the purpose of framing Constituent of Jammu and Kashmir State had completed its task by framing the Constitution for that state. Reliance was placed on the historic background in which this article, in which this article 370 was included in the Constitution, to urge that the powers under this article were intended to be conferred only for the limited period until the Constitution of the state was framed, and the President could not resort to them after the Constituent Assembly had completed its work by framing the Constitution of the state. The background of the legislative history to which reference was made was brought to our notice by learned counsel by drawing attention to the speech of Minister, the then Minister, Home Minister, Mr. N. Govalswamy Iyengar, when he moved the Constituent Assembly, Clause 306A of the bill, which now corresponds to Article 370 of the Constitution. It was stated by him that the conditions in Kashmir were special. The conditions in Kashmir were special and required special treatment. The special circumstances which referred was made by him were, one, that there had been a war going on within the limits of Jammu and Kashmir State. That was a ceasefire agreed at the beginning of the year, and the ceasefire was still on. Three, the conditions in the state were still unusual and abnormal, and they had not settled down. Four, the part of the state was still in the hands of rebels and enemies, that our country was entangled with the United Nations in regard to Jammu and Kashmir, and it was not possible to say when would be free from the entanglement. This is what I want to quote first, sir. The second is paraphrase, sir. We are not, let us see, we are not impressed by either of these two arguments advanced by Mr. Ramamurthy. So far, as a historical background concerned, the Attorney General appearing on behalf of the government also relied on its to urge the provisions of Article 370 should be held to be continuing in force because the situation that existed when this article was incorporated in the Constitution had not materially altered. And the purpose of introducing the article was to empower the President to exercise his discretion in applying the Indian Constitution while that situation remained unchanged. There is considerable force in this submission. That is what the judges say, sir. There is a considerable force in his submission. Sir, my question is, you are bringing a legislation, you are bringing a constitutional change. It's okay. As far as you are concerned, you are right. As far as we are concerned, that is not correct. Sir, you are not consulting the state legislature. You may say the state legislature is not in existence. Why this particular government, the then government, the same government which was in the last 5 years, they should have conducted the election, sir. During the Lok Sabha election, they should have conducted the assembly election also. But the will of the, that is what I suggest is, the will of the people is not reflected here. The will of the people will be truly reflected when there was an assembly. He may say, constitutionally it is correct, Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha, they can pass resolution, send it to President, get back as a bill can be passed because they have got a brute majority. Only by virtue of brute majority, these bills are passed every day. My friend, Parliament Affairs, very shrewd Parliament Affairs Minister, smart Parliament Affairs Minister, he is producing two bills, three bills every day, sir. It is just like a production hall of bills. And you are also, my friend, my speaker also smilingly approve everything without any discussion, half a discussion, half back discussion, no problem, sir. You are making use of that time. Sir, no, sir.
Yes, sir. So, come out, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Pass
holistically, everybody taking some, my friend, Joshi is very, very shrewd. He is always in preparation. He is always in producing the bills. He is also every day two bills, three bills. Almost 30, 35 bills he has passed in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Very efficient. My friend, Mr. Joshi, is very capable of handling anything because he would have been trained by my friend, Home Minister, that's not, you don't smile, it is a matter of, I am sharing my views only. So, my suggestion would be, to the Home Minister, straight away I am asking you, sir. My dear friend, you are too smart, and why should you interfere with me?
Half a minute. In Bajpayee government, when we ministered together, you may recall, we used to pass many bills, including your bills. So we work the same way.
Yes, I concur with your wish. At times, under Vajpayee's rule, underline that. I cannot say more over and above. Only thing is, sir, the thing is, what do you achieve? What is the end result of this? Yes, you are passing the bill. The bill is being definitely, it has to be passed by evening. Definitely, you got the majority. Definitely, we will be losing. We will be walking out or we will be voting against. But at the same time, the net result is, you are passing it. You are making the mighty state government into a municipality. Two municipalities are being created. One municipality by a joint authority, another municipality in another joint authority. The governors, our Home Minister is going to appoint the governors in the status of joint secretaries only. Andaman joint secretary, there's a governor, lieutenant governor, here only lieutenant governor. Who will care all these people, sir? Who will care are these people? Will there be a rule of law? Will there be a rule of law? My requirement is rule of law only. Whether ex-home minister, y-home minister, prepare the bill and send it and pass. But at the same time, what is the end result? The end result is more important. What is the end result? It will be under the head of the Lieutenant Governor and Governor, Joint Secretaries together. They cannot manage. They cannot, day-to-day administration or central government could not be managed by Joint Secretaries. Only the ministers have done. Ravi Shankar like this, ministers can have some say with the Joint Secretaries, not the new ministers. New ministers are not being heard by those people. I know what is going on. They could not do anything. They could not materially, they could not deliver the goods to the public. Even the senior minister says, they are not agreeing. This is what I am inferring from the central government administration, sir. My dear friend, only thing I want an end result to be, at the end of your reply, I should know, what are you going to do with this? In the past, many problems, intrusion, 7 people killed, intruders have been killed. You are asking the voice and counterpart, please come and take these bodies. Otherwise, the bodies will be there. You cannot dispose the bodies. Can't you hand over the to the rescue society? 2 days they were upon. They were asking, requesting the mighty government of India is going on begging the Baalu government, please come and take these bodies. Please come and take the bodies. Headlines, all TV's headlines, they are putting in the headlines. That is what is happening day-to-day affair. Security problem has not been solved. Our people in the borders are not safe. That is more important. Have you brought any solace to the people who are living at the edge of our borders? And porous borders we are having. Every day people are intruding. Terrorists they're coming and just walk free. Is there any solution to stop the terrorists coming into this, intruding into this? I want to know. The Home Minister is capable of answering. He may answer. But at the same time, end result will not be there. Only thing, more complication will arise. That is what we expect as an opposition, responsible opposition. I can only warn our friends. A friend in need is a friend indeed. I am your friend. We are all your friend. At the same time, you are capable of handling the situation. To deal with opposition, get a brute majority, I appreciate you. Really, I appreciate you. Even though you are an opposition member, even though you are all in opposition, I appreciate your might and coordination. See that your party is power even after 5 years. Nobody knows whether the drawbacks are not there. There are empty numbers of drawbacks and say, politically. But I don't want to say all this. But at the same time, you have got the majority and you are going to sail along this bill. My end result, at the end of the day, what we are going to achieve? Why don't we wait for some time? The true will be reflected by the legislature, local legislature only. Not by this parliament. Parliament is not known for that purpose. When there is no government, you can just administer. But at the same time, there is a clear-cut evidence is there. The judgment date is there. It reflects that. It reflects that particular legislative constitutional assembly is capable of handling such situation. But you have not given the opportunity to the Constitutional Assembly. You should have done it well in advance. You thought your bill is just to push your manifesto. In your manifesto, you said 370 will be implemented, erased. And 370 for your, since 370, you want to abrogate 370, that is being done by you. That's all. Just to see that wishes of your party. Not the public. If you are well enough, if you trust the public, the public can vote for you for 370, abrogation 370. You should have done it. The state selection should have done it. You are not trusting at that point of time. You are not trusting. I am not trusting the people. That is why I can get it passed in the Lok Sabha. That is why I am conducting the Lok Sabha. That is what IRS would have told. You simply put your people there. Whether they are defeated or elected, it is not a problem. My aim is to get the things brute majority somewhere here and there, but not in South. Why don't you get the things done in South? In Kerala, you cannot do it. In Tamil Nadu, you cannot do it. Why? What is the reason for that? You should come forward. You should come. You are smiling. Laugh. You are laughing, smiling. You are heckling it. But you cannot heckle at me. You cannot heckle at Kerala friends. There is no chance at all. Because elite people are not with you. The people who have got awareness, people who have got awareness, hey, simply sit down. You don't have any work, but sit down. Here, the parliament is known for people who have got backbone, not like you.
Why is he talking?
Sir, you have alerted me.
Sir, aapke aat hain.
No problem, sir. Sir, you have alerted me. No problem. I'm concluding. Only the last point, I am not scolding anybody, but only thing. You have alerted me because I have got backbone. Not the people with the backbone. Why all these things? I'm sorry, my friends are there, very senior friends are there. I have learned many things from them. And I have to learn from Ravi also. And Mr. Home Minister, you should have been somewhat, you should have conducted the legislature, the assembly election. Since you are very, very comfortable, you should have not, probably you should have not thought of it. And whatever the things, you know, corrective measures should be taken and we see that proper management of the border. The borders management is more important. The poorest should be immediately, the poorest condition should be arrested. And our people should live in peace. So, poison issue cannot be solved by this. Your aim should have been the